All right, doggies, let's get wet! Did you see that?
Amazing.
I have never seen anything like that before.
Hey, I'm Jim Zelasco here. This is Dock Diving Tales. Welcome, an event review. That's Baxter, by the way. And we are in Maryland here at the Eastern Championship Eastern Regional Championships, and it is such a great time. It's Sunday morning, the finals are going on, and as a testament to my voice, you know, it's just, you know, crazy here. I'm losing my voice, everybody's losing their voice, and yet everybody's still goofing around in the background because it's just so much fun hanging out with everybody, and it, you know, what a great weekend. Here, let's just roll some video, put some music to it, and I'll tell you what I thought.
So it all started out with registration check-in on Thursday. Then Friday morning, we all gathered for one giant handlers meeting where we were to meet some of the DockDog staff and get the lowdown on the weekend's competition, format, and activities. You were there. See? I see you right there. After that, the fun got started, both on and off the dock. This was a national event and the very first ever regional championships. Although Three Rivers Dock Dogs had held events at this location previously, it was the first time for a Dock Dogs national event and the first time for me at this location as well. I thought that the staff at WISP was fabulous. Always accommodating, courteous, and helpful. They seemed extremely willing to open up the whole place, allowing us to have so much fun, and accommodating to our dogs as well. I felt that they were very appreciative having us all there as their guests. I hope that they know how much many of us appreciate all their hospitality. At the competition, it was two pools, two docks, and a system that I felt worked very well. To me, there was no pressure to maintain a rigid schedule because everyone knew that there was likely going to be many conflicts with multiple dog handlers. And since everyone knew it was going to be that way, nobody panicked. It was all taken casual with an almost get here when you can attitude. I thought that was fabulous. All handlers needed to do was advise Dock 1 that they were held up on Dock 2. Simple. No pressure for the handlers or the crew. Maybe others didn't see this way, but as a handler, it made life simple for me, not feeling like I was being pulled in two directions at once. I think it was a combination of both the staff and handlers getting the job done, but taking the schedule nonchalantly so that nobody felt rushed. While this did have some waves running behind, there was also a fair amount of waves that got started early. Off the dock, it was just as much fun. The WISP Resort was a fabulous location to hold this event. All-inclusive, with so much more to do than just dock diving. Zip lines, ski lift rides, mountain coasters, and tons more to experience. Then you add in a talent show and after party, and all made for a busy and fun-filled weekend. For me, being at the very first regional championship, I thought it went extremely smooth. It was somewhat reminiscent of old nationals format, so it's not like Dock Dogs was starting all over again. They certainly had the experience from those past venues, but there were new rules, new staff, and still the logistics of it all to tend with. To me, it all seemed organized as if they had been running this regionals format for years. And also, the Dock Dogs staff, everyone, including all those that you may not even have seen working behind the scenes, I thought they did an incredible job. I know that each one of us's experiences are different. Doing these reviews, I don't go looking for a problem, but I do note them and bring them up when I feel it's relevant. In the case of this event, I couldn't find much wrong at all. Okay, I do have one item to note, and it's hardly worth mentioning, but what happened to all the garbage cans? On Friday, we seemed good. Then come Saturday morning, it's like half of them disappeared. But you know what? If that's my worst complaint, just chalk it up as saying Jim really had nothing to complain about. With regards to an audience, this regional championship crowd consisted mostly of our own. There were some locals that came out to watch, and even a few wanted to try DockDogs. But there wasn't even what I'd consider to be more than just a mild group of interested spectators as they passed by on their way to and from the resort's other attractions. But that was fine with me. Little to no Flexi League groupies to negotiate, making your way between the pools, with plenty of space, and plenty of space to take pictures and video. On Thursday night, winds kicked up and there were a few easy-up casualties. On Friday night, a pretty good storm rolled in, but DockDog's crew and some fellow competitors ran about through Dogtown trying to protect what they could. I'm sure their efforts are greatly appreciated by those that were not prepared. The storm didn't seem to affect much at the resort or with the competition area as far as I know, with the exception of a brief power outage that evening. The grounds of this facility are beautiful. Tucked up between mountains with green as far as you can see. Much of the facility's activities blend nicely into the landscape, providing a picturesque backdrop for this event. Dogtown was laid out on blacktop, which amplified the 90 degrees heat of the weekend. But they did lay out some crossing points with mats for our dogs to help protect their paws. I'm careful to minimize my dog's time on the blacktop whenever possible, and although we did a lot of running back and forth at times, they did not have any issues with their paw pads. I feel it's a combination of knowledge, experience, and common sense when confronted with an event that's set up on blacktop and it's going to be hot out. I think anyone that was conscious of the heat on their dog's paws was probably just fine. You also need to consider, regardless if it's blacktop or grass, those kinds of temperatures call for extra water for both humans and canines. There was decent space for Dogtown, but its layout needed to adhere to the local fire codes, so it may have seemed somewhat inconvenient to some. Nevertheless, it was laid out mostly by club, so the clubs could tent together. You were allowed to drive up and drop off your things, but cars weren't allowed in the crating area. You could park nearby, and if you really wanted to, just work directly from your car. By the way, I'm not a big fan of the club crating areas. I guess if you're having some sort of contest, it's okay, but I've made some really great friends because I unintentionally set up next to a stranger. Besides, people will group together anyway if they want to. I guess what I'm saying is that, in my opinion, it's not always necessary, even at this level. The staging area for the dogs was just off the blacktop on the grass. That certainly made it nice. Porta-potty restrooms for humans were located at each end of Dogtown. They were pretty convenient and usually line-free. We were tented just next to a set of them. Fortunately, we were upwind all weekend. Once in a while, when someone would enter, we'd play the guess if it's a number one or number two game. Facilities for the doggies was plenty, and you could easily space yourself away from the competition and other dogs so that your dog could do their business. They may have been fine going on a parking island, or you could take them over to a huge grassy area near the bottom of the ski slopes. Overall, I had a really good time, and I spoke with a few fellow competitors about the weekend's events to get their impressions too. Here's what they had to say.
Okay, Eastern Regional Championships, I found Penny and... Thank you. I found Penny and Tiffany. How you guys having it? How you guys liking this weekend?
Oh, it's great. We love it. We love it.
All right. Well, here we are, Eastern Regional Championships. I found Nancy Aiken making the drive from Georgia. Nancy, how'd you and Sally do this weekend?
Well, I can say honestly that Sally and I had a great time. That's how we did. We finished right around the middle of the pack with most of it, but we had a blast. Saw a lot of friends, and Sally had fun jumping.
Excellent. Great. And it was great to see you here. And once again, you know, it's just a fantastic weekend for everyone. I don't think there's any winners or losers. I think everybody won because it's so much fun.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I would do it all over again tomorrow.
All right. DockDogs Eastern Regional Championships, and I have found Randy Brees. Randy is the winner of DockDogs Has Talent.
Thank you. It was good.
And I just got the word that Riley is going to Worlds.
Woo!
with a 9 foot in novice.
All right, Riley, great job. Randy, how do you like the event?
Oh, it's been nice. It's been great to stay at the hotel, and the venue is great. The people were really nice, and we've been having a good time.
Hey, look, I found Trent Steele. He's collecting finals ribbons here. Oh my gosh, what a great job you guys did here.
Thank you.
How's the weekend for you?
Oh, it's been great for us. I mean, you know, I just throw the toy. He does all the work.
I know.
You know, so, but, you know, we tried our best, and we got first place in Masters and second place in EV Cadet. So
awesome.
I'm pretty happy.
Awesome. Congratulations.
Well, thank you.
You'll be at Worlds.
Yes, I will.
Good job. Congrats.
Off.
Woohoo. All right. I found Frank Moroff here, Eastern Regionals. Frank, how you guys doing this weekend?
We're doing great. We made Elite Finals, the number two spot. So we're thrilled. We're just thrilled.
So awesome. And what do you think of this whole complex?
I came to Three Rivers event here last year, and it was fantastic. And I was just overly excited that they had the regionals here. This is a great venue, and it's only 2.5 hours from my house, so couldn't ask for more.
I found Joey Spurlock. He's trying to get away from me here. Joey, how you guys doing this weekend?
Well, good so far. Brock made Sonic finals, and Rusty made Top Gun and Turbo finals.
Wow, so you are doing good. You're having a good weekend here. And what do you think of this event overall?
I think it's great. The setup's great. The hotel is really close, so walking distance for everything.
Right, all nice and self-contained. That's what makes it so great about this place.
And then the party last night was a lot of fun.
I had fun, too. That's why my voice is like this. I found Kevin Meese here. Kevin, what do you think of the Eastern Regional Championships? How are you liking the weekend?
I think the place is great. The venue is great. It's really nice here.
Right? It's a fantastic spot that you guys actually found for everyone through Three Rivers.
Yeah, we had a real, our club event was here, and it was really nice with the rides and different things that you can do.
Right, excellent. Well, thanks. Good luck.
Okay, thank you.
I found Angie Jones here. Angie's got Nestle, and Angie was just telling me how excited she is, and why are you so excited?
I'm excited because this is our ninth season of doing DockDogs, and this is his first big air final at a championship event. So it took him 9 seasons to get here. He's 10 years old. He's like, okay, now I can make the finals.
9 seasons. Yeah. You have certainly earned it, that's for sure. And so have you.
Thanks. So we're going to have fun. We're going to enjoy ourselves.
Last but not least, I want to touch base on the Saturday Night Social featuring DockDogs Has Talent. The evening started off with some food and friends just visiting, talking about the day's events, and relaxing waiting for the show to get started. Then it was time for the main feature, DockDogs Has Talent. And yes, they do. While the hosting could have been better, the acts were a blast. A great deal of originality and talent resides within DockDogs handlers. I love how those participated put it all out there to entertain. They weren't shy, and they made it so much fun. I personally thank them all for participating and making mine and everyone else's evening such a joy. Here's a little sample to reminisce.
Oh! It's New Year's
Season. Oh! Jump far in big air, shoot high in EV, swim as fast as you can, it's be your tree, and then as I
Once that show was over, the party continued with an after party that featured music and karaoke. The Bold and the Daring grabbed the microphone and sang us out for the evening. It was a great final night with DockDogs Has Talent stars out under the stars after a sun-filled day playing with our own furry stars on the dock.
Young man.
I've been to a great deal of DockDogs events, many of them very memorable. I can confidently say that this event definitely ranks in my top 5. This will be a difficult regional championship to top, so to all of those going to other regional championships I say, get involved, don't be shy. Show us your talent, show us your big jumps, and show us your excitement on and off the dock. You, the DockDogs competitors, make the fun. And no matter the outcome in the end, don't forget to keep admiring the best thing you've ever brought back from any dock diving event, your dog. I leave you with some extra footage and playing the song that won DockDogs Has Talent at the Eastern Regional Finals. Here's Having Fun at DockDogs, sung by Randy Breeze.
I got my dog right here. We're gonna head on out, gonna have some fun. We're gonna scream and shout at DockDogs. Having fun at DockDogs. Gonna set him up, he's gonna run real fast, gonna throw his toe, he's gonna make a splash at DockDogs, having a blast at DockDogs. I'll tell him, jump far in big air, shoot high in EV, swim as fast as you can, and speed retrieve. And then there's Iron Dog, if you play all three. Not only with my dog, but hanging out with my friends. Gonna barbecue when the day is ended at DockDogs. Lots of friends at DockDogs. We're like a family, why don't you come along? You'll be addicted to it. Jump far in big air, shoot high in EV, swim as fast as you can, and speed retrieve. And then there's Iron Dog, if you play all three. Well, for the sport we love, we travel all around, got the crate and bowl, the car is all packed. DockDogs. We're gonna do our best, that's what matters most. You can check us out from coast to coast at DockDogs. See you soon at DockDogs. Just tell them, jump far in big air, shoot high in EV, swim as fast as you can, and speed retrieve. Dream.